looks like it landed on Blake Griffin's foot. Might have rolled that left ankle a little bit. Go back and take a look at his post defense. Watch on the shot as he lands. Steps back and he lands, and there's that roll. Ooh, he rolled it pretty good, too. Ouch.
Trust me, that hurts.
They're going to look at it again because it was borderline, I don't want to say dirty play, but you can really get a guy hurt.
Yeah, it's Blake this time. Does Blake stick that right foot out?
Ouch. Just sticks it under him.
The 17 shoe? And you think those guys are that accurate, you better think again. That was an accident.
Oh, I'm sure it was an accident, but it always happens with him. When the Rockets are playing, a lot of accidents, types of players. Like I said, he plays hard all the time.
That really fire up superstars.
It's going to be a flagrant, penalty one. So James is going to get three. And
see Blake trying to get a little...
Damn, I wish I could get somebody like a toy in the draft.
Discover how you,
you know who that is?
And country. Visit goarmy.com/armyguard.
Toy. Toy Televolu, niggas will play for Alabama.
Combine, you worked with the safeties, but you were listed as a DB. How would you describe your skill set?
I said just that, defensive back. I can move inside corner, outside corner. I move the safety. I got to play in the secondary wherever you need me. I play in the box a little bit, so I'm going to play there. Just athletic, versatile, and I just combine all that to allow me to play in my good position.
Did you leave Indianapolis doing what you wanted to do? Did you show the scouts and the talent evaluators everything you wanted to show them?
It was, I think I did a pretty good job. I think I could have tested a little bit better, but I was happy with my overall results. And, you know, on the drills, I think I did a real good job. I showed them I could do all the things that they wanted me to do on the field. So I was happy with my performance.
I'm told by the people here that you were an excellent interview, in some cases their favorite interview of the combine. How do you think you most impressed them? Was it talking football?
Player in the draft, and I'm not going to tell you who it is, but he's got a good breakdown. I want to start with this. John Elway came out yesterday and just said, hey, I'm going to keep swinging at quarterback. I don't care. I can deal with the misses. And, you know, I tend to agree with him. You don't necessarily in terms of franchise quarterback.
I'm going to tell you something, Colin. If people really understood how hard it is to find a franchise quarterback, that's hard. Let me give you a number, right? Find that if Philly gets in, and there's a bunch of them in the record home run, you know, franchise quarterback, but they are rare. They're rare.
Bill Belichick always put up with a little crap, but in recent years, Jamie Collins, out. Kevin Jones, out. Malcolm Butler, I'm sick of it. I'm not saying Belichick has to change, right?
around, they always tell you, make sure you aim for the top shoulder. Because if you don't aim for the top shoulder, Ben Roethlisberger gets out of there. Right? Because he sidesteps you. Watch his right foot after the third step. Go running. Right. Bam. Upfield. Now look at his angle. Now watch where his angle goes. Quarterback has no chance to get away. That's not just athleticism. That's understanding where I'm weak at. If he does anything else that comes inside, his help can't help him. If he stays outside, everything else. I've watched play after play. Oh, my gosh, I'll never forget 2009. Ben Roethlisberger, we playing him in Pittsburgh. And all our DB has to do is stay outside. And he does. He come inside. It's this type of play that makes this kid. I'm telling you. Right now, he's rated on the board. Some people board top five,
yeah,
right? Probably fifth pick. But I'm just telling you, overall, you talk about Cleveland having two picks,
yeah,
right?
Well, my thing was, a couple days ago, didn't I do a mock and I had him taking Darnold and Minka?
And Minka.
To me, guys, the quarterback changer, and to me, Minka's the one player in the draft you can't miss.
You can't miss him, and he's a culture changer. It's one of the things, C.J. Mosley is that. It's a lot of those Alabama players, because of the type of system that they come from, is ran almost like a professional team.
Yeah.
So they study from a totally different level.
By the way, Minka came in to the National Football League. He came into Alabama as a freshman.
Mm-hmm.
Played Nick Saban's a defensive back guy, and he played their key position in the secondary, and Nick gave it to him as a true freshman. And he's also a great special teams player. Yeah. Like, remember the Patrick Patterson that went to LSU?
Absolutely.
I remember Herm Edwards.
Set up. Because if I don't, he will blow me up. Huh. What the fuck? What? Wow, they just gave this nigga some. Okay. Come on, bro. You see this?
Thank you.
This nigga done had the ball this whole fucking first quarter. I should have. I didn't have the money to do it. Thank you.
2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to CenturyLink Field. After this, a good chance. This is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert.
Oh my god, that was a that was a tutty. Oh my god. That was a tutty.
Time here.
Oh. What? Oh my. Oh man, that's me. That's on me. Wow, bro. I don't understand this game sometimes. Come on with this game. They gave that to him? This nigga, wow. Okay. Level cell. Level cell. Thank you. Oh, come on. Fuck, bro. Damn, I should have just ran a regular fade. Oh my god. I should have ran a regular fade route. Take it. God. This nigga, man. Bro, I've never played somebody make this many audibles, bro. Like, damn. My bad, man. Oh. This nigga, he won, bro. Oh my God. Oh.